Hello friends, take a look at my new one-handed controller. It's for the Switch. It looks a little bit like a squid, kind of, so I call it the Squid-Con. You hold it like a mouse, like this, and push on these tentacles, I guess. They allow you to reach every button on a pair of Joy-Cons with just one hand. A for A, B for B, X for X, Y for Y, one for each, Squid Pro Quo. Bend your fingers back a little bit and you'll find the shoulder buttons. L, ZL, R, and ZR. Can you figure out how this works? How this is connected there? I bet the mechanism is nothing like what you're thinking. Oh, and plus! Here it is. Next, you use your thumb and your little pinky to move the sticks. I tested this with a lot of beta testers and I was surprised to find that some people like it this way. With the index and the pinky. Some use their ring finger and their thumb. And for that reason, the head of the squid here is designed so you can hold it comfortably in many different ways. The trick is that you can rest the side of your palm here. It's awkward at first, but you get used to it much faster than you think. Your fingers are more dexterous than you think. Speaking of dexterous, it's ambidextrous. You can use it with your left hand as well. It's symmetrical. The D-pad buttons can be reached by your thumb if you're right-handed, or your pinky if you're left-handed. I know it's not ideal, but luckily not many games use these D-pad buttons so much nowadays. In any case, if you need more buttons in easy-to-reach places, I've got you covered because I've added these side buttons on the side. This can be assigned to any action in your game, so if you wish you could reach any of the functions on the D-pad faster, you might assign them to your side buttons, or maybe you want a second B button here, I don't know. It's up to you. So in that way you can reach all the buttons that you would find on a two-handed controller like this, with just one hand. I'm going to give you a taste of your own turntable. This is not time for cracking jokes. Squid while you were ahead. And here's an Easter egg that I designed into the device. There's a secret compartment here at the bottom of the device. You push on this and release these two bow-like components. What's going on here? These actually slot into these slots and add two extra buttons, also configurable. Now, don't think that these are going to be the most comfortable to use, but if you need one extra assignable extra button, why not try and use these Easter eggs? The way these work is they actually hit on these buttons, SL, SR, these little hidden shoulder buttons on the side of your Joy-Cons. My previous one-handed controller design relied on you dragging the device against the surface, but this time around the device is designed to stay put. For that you can use these felt feet. There's a standard tripod mount here, so you can have it at the end of a tripod. Or an amps mount system, so use that if you want to take this out motorcycling. In case you don't have the screws for it, here's another secret for you. Break away these tabs, and there's some hidden screws for you. Now here's something to think about. How did those screws get inside there in the first place? So I've shown you how it is to play with. I personally play with two hands normally, so I'm not the best judge of how well this works. And for that reason, I've had about a dozen beta testers around the world try this for the past few months. So I have some confidence in saying that I think it works quite okay. I still have some of these prototype pieces left, so if you don't mind a version with an older design or some production defects, and you'd like to try one of these out, please get in contact. I might be able to send you one of these for the price of shipping. And after those are out, I'm gonna be selling version 1.0 on my web store, so please take a look. So the face buttons, ABXY, they are hit on by this mess of button extending arms. They all go through this circular bit that I call the turbine. So each arm goes in, look at the A button, it goes in and it comes out the other end. Yet there are four similar arms and they all have to navigate their way through here without touching each other. So it's a complicated shape, so it all goes together almost like a 3D puzzle. But luckily I don't have to worry about putting it together every time because this piece actually prints in place. It comes out of the printer already assembled. And that's where this funny shape of the turbine comes from. The smooth shapes and the tentacle-like structure are actually just born out of the functionality. Because these are produced with a 3D printer, most of the pieces in this design have some peculiar shapes, and most of it is to do with ease of printing, including the shape of the squid fin, in fact. So the tentacles and the head of the squid actually came about by natural selection almost. It evolved into this shape. Instead of me starting out with an idea of making an animal-inspired shape. And then the shoulder buttons. These run on this circuit of sorts that's downstairs. It's not a circuit of electronics, it's a circuit of flexures. So these different elements have different thicknesses. Some of them are thin, some of them are thick. That makes some of them rigid and some of them flexible a little bit. And the end result is, once it's all sandwiched and clamped together, certain bits of it move independently and certain bits work as structural elements. Four independent arms that connect the shoulder buttons to these buttons on your fingers, much like this turbine bit does, but in a totally different way of thinking. And in fact, the side buttons and the eject mechanism also use the same sort of design. Flexure is pretty cool. Whereas the face buttons have a shaft and moving bits, the rest of the design is monolithic. There's no moving parts in a way. It looks like it's moving, but it's only bending, so there's no wear. Four shoulder buttons, two side buttons, and two eject buttons. All of that is from a single piece, can you believe it? And finally, look at this. The whole design goes together with no glue and no fasteners. It just snaps together and you can always take it apart as well. You might know that 3D printed plastic parts have these layer lines. It's almost like a grain to the material that makes it weak in one direction and strong in others. Here, the different pieces have their grain in different directions. So the result is that they reinforce each other, helping each other's weaknesses. I'm pretty happy with how sturdy it is. I'd like to ask you for comments as well, because there are already a few issues that I would perhaps like to fix in a future version too. First is the face buttons. So the way that they work is that this arm pushes on the respective button on the controller's side, but because of this distance and it having a U shape like this, there is some flex to it. So these are not infinitely solid. So I have to say it's a bit mushy. Where a normal button stops quite solidly after you've activated the action, these ones keep going for a little bit. So there's a little bit of mushiness behind the action of the button. It's fine to play with, but it could be nicer. Apart from making these out of metal or something, I don't have a good solution to this. What do you think? Is there a way to make these more rigid? The other issue is with the palm shape. I'm pretty happy with this. It works with a variety of size and shape of hand and different play styles and grips. And in fact, most of the time designing this was spent on perfecting this shape based on a lot of feedback. Most of the rest of the time went into making this eject mechanism click nicely like this. Ah, perfect. But perhaps this shape could be even better. I'm not sure. Should it be more curved like this? Should it be more flat? Should there be an adjustment that you could make for larger or smaller hands? Is it too ambitious to make it ambidextrous? Should it be a non-symmetric shape so you'd have a choice between left and right-handed use? I don't know. In any case, I hope you like the design. Maybe you can use some of the tricks that I've used in your own projects. And until next time, thank you for watching.